All right, welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. And joining me now is Peter Akerley. He's the CEO of Erdene Resource Development Corp. And Peter, it's good to see you again. How are you?
Very well, Steve. Good to see you as well.
Yeah, so significant news out from the company today, and we'll talk about that in just a second. It all has to do with your project, Bayan Khundii. Did I say that correct?
That's right, Bayan Khundii.
Good, I'm glad. Well, there you go. So let's talk about the project itself first. Just get everyone up to date on what we're talking about here.
Sure. The Bayan Khundii project is one of a multitude of deposits and prospects that we found in southwestern Mongolia. And really what sets these deposits apart is grade. Our first discoveries out here were 7 to 10 meters of an ounce of gold. We were picking up samples that were 4,000 grams per ton. And that was several years ago when we proceeded to drill off the Bayan Khundii deposit. Subsequent to that, we discovered the Dark Horse deposit, which is also part of the feasibility we'll discuss today. In both of these exceptionally high-grade deposits, Bayan Khundii averages 3.5 grams and Dark Horse 7 grams within the top 150 meters of surface. So a real anomaly in our business to be able to find deposits of this grade exposed or very near to surface. And that makes up the key components of the feasibility study, but it's really just the first or the initial foundation being built here in the Khundii Minerals District, where we have other deposits that we're now drilling off and plan to continue to introduce into this initial development through expansion and or extension of mine life in the future.
Yeah, you mentioned the feasibility study that you put out today. It really is some strong numbers to begin with. What stood out to you, Peter?
Well, again, I think it's great, Steve. You know, that drives the economics in this. But when you can generate ore that's going to go into your plant at 4 grams per ton, it generates some tremendous economics. So this project will produce about 80,000 ounces per year after we get up and running in the first year. But it'll be providing us as shareholders about $60 to $80 million per year in after-tax cash flow. So a very substantial opportunity for our shareholders to benefit from a high-grade mine that we see as the first step in the development of the Khundii Minerals District.
So what's the timeline here? Obviously, you've got this report out now that really sort of sets the stage. Maybe give everyone an update on what's going to happen over the next couple of years, because it's going to be a pretty quick timeline.
Well, that's right. And one of the things that sets us apart is we came out in 2020, just prior to COVID, with the initial feasibility, and the project was somewhat delayed as a result of that timeline. But it's allowed us to finesse and move through all of the things you typically do after a feasibility is issued. So we're fully permitted. We're in the midst of early works. We're advancing this project very rapidly as we speak. We have a partner now who's provided the equity funding for the project, a $40 million US injection. So we're well underway, and our expectation is that we'll complete this facility by the end of 24 and go through commissioning late 24 for first gold in early 25.
Wow, it's an exciting time for you and the company. Congratulations on this report, and we'll continue to follow the story as it develops over the next couple of years. So, Peter, thanks so much. Good to see you again.
Thanks very much, Steve.